Guys, I am Neha Pariyani. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to learn about bills receivable book, bills payable book and problems relating to it. So let's begin. In my previous session, we have used this example of Gopal and have understood the concept of subsidiary book, right? And we know that basically there are 8 types of subsidiary books. And in our previous section, we have already discussed a problem about purchase book, sales book, purchase return book and sales return book, right? So if you have not watched that video yet, I will give you the link of that previous video at the end of this current video. Okay, so in today's session, we are going to discuss about bills receivable book and bills payable book. So what are bills receivable and bills payable books? So bills receivable book is an instrument or a legal agreement. So it's a legal agreement stating that customer agrees to make a full payment of the debts of a business at a later date. So in order to understand the meaning of bills receivable, first let's have a look at this example. So consider this is Nina and this is Sheena. Okay, so Nina is a shopkeeper. So she is owner of certain shop and Sheena is the customer. Okay, so Nina sells certain goods to Sheena. Remember, here the sales are made on credit basis. Okay, so whenever the credit basis sales are made, only then the bills receivable and bills payable are used. Alright, so Nina is selling certain goods to Sheena on credit. So Sheena, what she does is, she does not make the payment of money, that is cash. She makes a bill. Okay, so this is a bill. She gives the bill to Nina. She agrees to pay the amount on later date, in future. Okay, so when she uses the bill as a promissory note or the proof that the credit transaction is made, that will be known as bills of exchange. For Sheena, it is bills payable, and for Nina, it is bills receivable. Alright, so bills receivable is nothing but the amount. It is also known as account receivable. Okay, so the amount that Nina has to get from Sheena, or the amount that the seller has to get from his customer, so that will be known as bills receivable. This bills of exchange is bills receivable for Nina and it is bills payable for Sheena. Alright, so in a bill of exchange, it serves as a proof, right? It serves as an evidence, hence it is an instrument. So in every bills of exchange, the amount that is to be paid is mentioned along with the sign of both the parties, right? Signature, sign of both the parties is mentioned, right? So now you understood. Bills receivable is an instrument or a legal agreement. So it is a legal agreement between Nina and Sheena stating that the customer here is Sheena, right? So customer agrees to make full payment of debts. So she is promising to pay full payment of debts for a business on a later date. So she says that now I cannot pay the amount on later date, or in future I will pay you rupees 4000. So hence these are bills of exchange. So what is bills payable? Bills payable is also an instrument which refers to the debts or amount the customer has to pay to the seller or supplier. So here it refers to the amount that the customer has to pay to its seller or supplier, right? So now you're clear with the concept. Okay, so now let's head on to the problem. So we know that in bills receivable book and bills payable book, only the bills received and which are to be payable, only those transactions are taken into consideration, right? So let's have a look at the problem. Record the following transactions in bills receivable and bills payable book of Mr. James. Okay, so the first transaction is on October 1st, 2017, received a bill from Shrikant for 2 months for rupees 12,000. Okay, so here it's clearly mentioned that we are receiving a bill, received a bill. So hence it is a bills receivable, right? So what you need to do is, so first of all, this is the format of a bills receivable book. So the format of bills receivable book and bills payable book is somewhat different from purchase book, sales book and all first four types of books. Okay, so here it consists of serial number, date of receipt, it means that on which date the bills are received, from whom received. So from whom we are receiving the bills, the name of that person will be written, name of the acceptor, so who is agreeing to pay the amount. Okay, so here the person who is agreeing to pay the amount on future date, the name of that person will be mentioned, right? So where payable, if any information regarding where to pay the bills or where the payment is to be made is given in the problem, then it is mentioned in this column, right? So date of the bill, on which date the bill is drawn, and term. So here term refers to the term for which the credit is given, right? The gap that we will get to know in the question. Okay, so when due, so here you need to find out the due date after the after the term is completed, the due date on which we are going to receive the bills or the amount, so that will be calculated, right? So this is ledger folio column and this is final amount column. Okay, so the first transaction was received a bill from Shrikant. We are receiving bill from Shrikant for 2 months, right? So the term becomes 2 months for rupees 12,000. So this is bills receivable, right? So mention it in the bills receivable. That is serial number 1 and the date of bill is 2017 and October 1st, right? So we are receiving bill from Shrikant. So mention the name here, Shrikant. Okay, so name of the acceptor, who is accepting to pay the bills? Shrikant itself, right? We are receiving bill from Shrikant, it means that he is agreeing to pay, he is accepting to pay the amount in future date. So write the same name, Shrikant. And where payable, that information is not there in the transaction, right? So leave it as nil. Okay, so date of the bill, date of the bill becomes same, date of the receipt and date of the bill will be same. If any particular information is given that the bill is drawn on this date, then you need to mention the date there. So here nothing is given, so take it as it is, on October 1st 2017. So the term here is for 2 months, right? So he is agreeing to pay the amount after 2 months. So the term becomes 2 months, right? So now here you need to calculate due date. Okay, so let's see how to calculate it. So guys, this is the rough work. Okay, so we can write it as rough work. So when the what is the date of the bill? On October 1st, right? So October 1st to 2 months, right? From October 1st to November 1st and from November 1st to December 1st, 2 months are completed, right? So from October 1st to 2 months, October 1st and November 1st, November 1st and December 1st. So December 1st becomes the due date, right? So but here in every bills receivable and bills payable transaction, you need to give them 3 days grace days, that is 3 days extra, in order to, in if they fail to pay the amount on December 1st or within December 1st, 3 extra grace days will be given to every person, right? So December 1st plus 3 days, so the 3 days, not 3 months, okay, 3 days. So December 1st plus 3 days, the date become December 4th, right? So December 4th is the due date. So you understood how to calculate the due date, right? So in this case, December 4th becomes the due date. So right here, when due? December 4th. right? LF, ledger folio is nil, and the amount was rupees 12,000, right? 12,000. So the first transaction is completed. Next, on October 8th, gave acceptance. So here we are giving the acceptance, right? We are accepting to pay. Gave acceptance to Mrs. Deepa's bill for rupees 5,400 payable after 3 months, right? So here we are giving the acceptance. That means we are agreeing to pay Deepa's bill of rupees 5,400. It means that we have to pay rupees 5,400 to Deepa, Mrs. Deepa's bill after 3 months. So this is bills payable, right? So mention it in the bills payable book. So now the format of bills payable book is, this is serial number, date of the bill, whatever the date is given. So name of the drawer, who is drawing the bill on us. So name of that person is written, okay. So name of the payee. So this will also be same, right? Term, again the term which we like here in bills pay, bills receivable book, we mentioned term, right? So in the in bills payable book also, the term whatever is given in the question will be mentioned. So when due, again here you need to calculate due date, right? So this is ledger folio column, this will be nil. Amount, so what amount is given in the transaction, you need to mention that. And remarks, if there are any remarks, then you can mention it in the remarks column, okay? So look at the entry. We are giving acceptance to Mrs. Deepa's bill for rupees 5,400 payable after 3 months, right? So the date is October 8th, 2017. So the serial number is 1, date is 2017 and October 8th, right? We are giving to acceptance to Mrs. Deepa bill, Deepa's bill. So here you can write it as Mrs. Deepa. And here again same, Mrs. Deepa. So the term was 3 months, right? When due? Now you need to calculate the due date, okay? So from October 8th to 3 months, right? So from October 8th to November 8th, 1 month, November 8th to December 8th, 1 month, and December 8th to January 8th, 2018, right? 1 month. So January 8th, 2018, all right? So plus 3 grace days. So January 8th to 9th, 9th to 10th, and 10th to 11th. So January 11th, 2018 becomes the due date. Clear? So write it here. In 2018, January 11th. So the amount that is to be paid was 5,400. So any remarks are not given, hence this is nil. Alright. So the now the second transaction is completed. Now look at third. October 13th. Acceptance received from Chetan for 1 month for rupees 2,000. So here we have given the acceptance, right? Gave acceptance, that means we are agreeing to pay. Now we are receiving the acceptance. Acceptance received. It means that Chetan is agreed to pay amount rupees 2,000 in future after 1 month. So this is bills receivable, right? So always remember, when we give acceptance, it is bills payable. When we receive the acceptance, it is bills receivable. Okay. So mention this in the bills receivable book. Serial number is second, right? Date October 13. Acceptance received from Chetan, right? So write here Chetan. And here also same. Who is agreeing to pay? Chetan is agreeing to pay. So where payable is not given. So nil. And the date of the bill is same, October 13th. The term is 1 month, right? So what will be the due date? From October 13th to 1 month. So 1 month will be November 13th, right? November 13th. Plus 3 grace days. Plus 3 days. For every transaction, you need to give 3 extra days. 3 grace days, okay? So the November 13th, 14th and 15th, right? So the due date becomes November 16th, sorry, 13 to 14, 14 to 15 and 15 to 16, 3 days. So the due date becomes November 16th. That is 2017 itself, okay? So November 16th. The amount was rupees 2000. Okay, so the third transaction is completed. Now look at fourth transaction. On October 21st, accepted a bill 2 months dated. MD refers to months dated for rupees 6750 drawn by Asha and company, right? So here Asha and company is drawing bill on us, okay? They are drawing bill on us and we are accepting to pay, okay? So it is a bills payable drawn by Asha and company and accepted by us. That means, it means that we are accepting to pay amount rupees 6750 after 2 months to Asha and company. So this is bills payable, right? So mention it in the bills payable. Serial number 2. Date October 21st. We accept drawn, it is drawn by Asha and company. Right? Name of the pay. Pay here refers to we are paying to Asha and company itself. Right? So write the same. Asha and company. The due date was 2 months dated. So here 2 months. Right? So what will be the due date from October 21st to 2 months? So October 21st to November 21st, 1 month. November 21st to December 21st, 2 months. So December 21st plus 3 days. So December 24th, 2017, right, becomes the due date. So write it here. 2017 December 24th. What was the amount? So the amount was rupees 6750. 6750. Alright. So the next transaction. On October 29th, a bill at 60 days dated for rupees 5000 drawn by Warner Andros was accepted this day, right? So this is also drawn by Warner and Rose on us, right? So remember, whenever it is given the drawn by any other company or any other person, that will be bills payable, right? And we are accepting it to pay after 60 days. So in every previous transaction, the term was given in months, right? 2 months, 1 month, right? 3 months. But in this transaction, it is given in days, that is 60 days. So here you need to calculate exact 60 days, right? So how will you calculate? This is bills payable, right? So first of all, mention it in the bills payable book. Serial number is 3. So bill is drawn by, date was October 29th. So the bill is drawn by Warner and Rose, right? So name of the pay, we are paying to same person, Warner and Rose. The term is 60 days, right? Here 2 months and 3 months. So we have written M. Here it's 60 days. So you need to write D, okay? So what will be the due date from October 29th to 60 days, right? From October 29th to October 31st will be 29, 30 and 31st. So 3 days are completed, right? From October 30 up to October 31st is completed. So 3 days are completed, right? So next, November. In November we have 30 days, right? So out of 60, 3 days are completed. So remaining are 57 days, right? So in November we have 30 days, right? So 30 days are minus. So remaining are 27 days, right? So in December, 27 days we need, right? So December 27 plus 3 days extra, right? So December 30 becomes the due date. So in October 29 to 31st are 3 days. So from 60 days, 3 days are gone, right? In November we have 30 days, so full November month. So again from 57, 30 days are gone. So we need still 27 days. So from December 1st to December 27th plus 3 extra days will be December 30th, right? So the due date becomes December 30th. December and December 30th. So the amount to be payable was 5,000. 5,000. So there are no remarks, so mention nil. Look at the last transaction. On October 31st, received a bill from Arjun for 40 days dated for rupees 9,000. So here we are receiving a bill, right? In the first transaction also we received a bill. It is a bills receivable. In the last transaction also received a bill. We are receiving from Arjun. So it is a bills receivable. Mention it in the bills receivable book. Serial number 3, October 31st. We are receiving bill from Arjun. And name of the acceptor, who is accepting to pay? Same person, Arjun. So where payable is not given. Date of the bills becomes same, October 31st. So the term is 40 days. Right? So when do you calculate the due date? From October 31st to 40 days. So November 40 days, right? November full month. So November 30. So 30 days are gone, right? Remaining are 10. So December 1 to December 10. December 1 to December 10. The December 10 is the date. Plus 3 extra days. Right? So December 13 becomes the due date. Understood? We needed 40 days. In November month we have full 30 days. Full month is gone. Remaining are 10. From December 1st to December 10th. The December 10th becomes the date. Plus when we add 3 extra date, 3 extra days, December 13 becomes the due date. So here write it as December and 13. The amount rupees 9,000. Alright. So now recording of all the transaction is completed. Right. So now what you need to do is you just need to total the amount column. So the total of this will be 23,000, right? So this is the total on month end of bills receivable book. Remember guys, the total is done only at the month end, right? So when all the transactions of the month are recorded, then the total is done. So 23,000 is the total of bills receivable book for the month of October. Okay, so total of the bills payable book. So the total becomes 17,150. So on the month end, that is October 31st, the total of bills payable book is 17,150. Okay, so this was all about the problem. Okay, so this was all about the bills receivable books and bills payable book. In my next video, we will be discussing about various other forms of subsidiary books. For any questions and queries, you can ask me in the comment section below. Don't forget to watch my next videos. Also, subscribe to my channel and press the bell button. I will see you in my next video. Till that, happy learning.